Morning, everyone. Welcome either in person or virtually to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Dan Sloan. I'm a member of our board of directors. Joining me today doing our translation is Mary Joyce. For those attending directly here at the club, kindly put your cell phones on manner mode. For our guests online, please send your questions for our speaker to the link on our webpage. We've already started receiving some of these questions. We'll try to get to everyone in our session that's slated to last about 1 hour. Almost exactly 10 years ago, Japan experienced a devastating earthquake, tsunami, and nuclear disaster that even a decade later, the country is still recovering from. This month, we will welcome a number of guests to the club with key vantage points to the events of March 2011 and how it affected lives in the nation. Mary, you just go.
はい、本日、外国特派員協会へようこそ。司会はこちらの協会の理事をしております、ダン・スローンと申します。そして通訳はメリー・ジョイスが務めさせていただきます。本日、直接お越しになっている方は、ぜひ携帯の方をマナーモードにお願いいたします。そしてオンラインご参加の方は、オンラインでフォームがありますので、質問の方はそちらの方でご提出ください。もうちょうど10年前になりますが、日本では地震、津波、そして原発事故を経験して、今も、まだ復興の途中にあるという現状があります。今週はですね、今月はさまざまなその出来事についてお話しいただく方々にスピーカーとしてお越しいただいております。
Our speaker today, Katsunobu Sakurai, was then mayor of Minamisoma, a coastal city in Fukushima Prefecture that was then home to about 71,000 people. In the wake of the triple disasters that left over 1,100 disaster-related deaths in the city, the nuclear meltdown at Fukushima Daiichi facility led to a mass exodus from Minamisoma as the city was within the 20 kilometer no-go zone.
本日のスピーカーは桜井勝信氏ですが、当時7万1000人のある福島県南、という人口のある福島県南相馬市の市長でございました。その複合災害により 南相馬市では約1800人の方が、災害関連死も含めて犠牲になったんですけれども、その原発のメルトダウンにより、南相馬市は20キロ圏内にあったため、多くの、避難民もその市から出て行きました。
Not everyone could or would leave, and Mayor Sakurai's YouTube post on the plight of 南相馬 drew global attention to the hardship faced by residents and many others in the Tohoku region, which ultimately brought much needed aid.
もちろん当時離れることのできない、または離れることしない方もたくさんいました。桜井市長が当時ですね、南相馬市の状況を YouTube で世界に発信したことによって、多くの方々が南相馬市、または東北の他の地域の、方々が直面している問題について、注目が集まることになりました。その結果、必要とされていた支援が届けられるということにもなりました。
A decade later, the population of Minamisoma now stands around 53,000, and the city has new additions such as the Fukushima Robot Test Field, which Prime Minister Suga recently visited. Fukushima, known for its Gambappe spirit, still faces challenges, which we'll hear about today.
そして10年が経った今なんですが、南相馬市の人口は約5万3000人となりました。そして最近ですね、例えば菅総理が最近視察された福島ロボット実験場などという新たな施設も増えています。
Sakurai-san served as mayor from 2010 to 2018 and has continued to comment publicly on current events, such as the government's calling the Tokyo Olympics a recovery games, either from the disasters of 2011 or the COVID pandemic, as well as the torch relay, saying it did not underscore a true recovery.
桜井さんはですね、2010年から2018年まで市長を務められていたんですけれども、その後も多くの公の場で様々な、例えばオリンピック、いわゆる復興オリンピック、復興五輪についてのコメントですとか、そのトーチリレー、その2011年の災害、そして今のコロナの状況を乗り越えるためのいわゆる復興についてのコメントなどもたくさんされている方でございます。
Sakurai-san, now 65, joins us, I believe, from Minamisoma.To detail what has changed since those tragic events of a decade ago, and detail how Minamisoma continues to recover. With no further ado, Mayor Sakurai.
桜井氏はですね、現在65歳でございますが、本日も遠隔で南相馬からお話をしていただきます。この10年の間、何が変わったのか、何がどういうふうに復興が進められているのかについてお話をいただきます。では桜井さん、よろしくお願いします。
はい、おはようございます。 震災から間もなく明後日で10年経ちますけれども、南相馬市は震災、とりわけ原発事故で、本当に大きな犠牲を強いられました。大津波がやってきて636人が犠牲になりました。そして原発事故が起きて7万1500人の市民のうち6万人以上が市街へと避難を余儀なくされてきました。まあ、10年経ちますけれども、まあ、残念ながら転出してしまった市民は1万人以上を超えていますし、今現在も市街に4000人を超える市民が避難生活を余儀なくされています。
Good morning. まあ、Good morning. We are now at almost exactly 10 years since the disaster. Indeed, the day after tomorrow will mark that date.The people of Minami Soma experienced great suffering and sacrifice as a result of this disaster, and especially because of the nuclear power plant disaster. First of all, 636 residents of the city of Minami Soma were killed in the great tsunami. Following this, the population, which was 71,500 people at the time, of this, around 60,000 were forced to evacuate from the city as a result of the nuclear disaster.10 years have passed since then. However, unfortunately, a lot of people have left the city. Around 10,000 or more than 10,000 have moved away from Minami Soma. And indeed, there are still around 4,000 people who are having to continue to live their lives in evacuation.
直接津波で亡くなった636人も福島県では最大ですし、避難によって避難が原因で亡くなられたという方々が今日現在まで520人に上ってしまいました。これは、全国ダントツで本当に一番の亡くなられた数なので、本当に亡くなられた方々に対しては心からご冥福をお祈り申し上げたいと思いますし、家族親族の皆さんはまだ心が癒えていないと思いますので、改めてお見舞いを申し上げたいと思います。
So、in Minami Soma, 636 residents were killed directly in the tsunami which occurred at that time. This is the highest number of deaths in all of Fukushima Prefecture. Not only this, but as of today, 520 people are said to have died of deaths for reasons related to the evacuation or so-called disaster-related causes.This is by far the highest number of anywhere in the whole of Japan. And indeed, for all of these people, these great losses of life, this is something which I would like to express my deepest condolences, and particularly considering the bereaved families who are still, of course, not yet fully healed, of course, I would like to really express my deepest sympathies to them.
まあ、この大きな災害から私たちは何を学び、そして何をこれからしなければならないかということを真摯に考える必要があると思います。
I think that it's very important for us to really deeply or sincerely think about what indeed we did learn from this major disaster and what we need to do from now.
私は南相馬市長として当時から現在までもそこの災害を通じて最も大切だというふうに感じてきたのは、人の命をどうやって守るかということであります。
As the mayor of Minami Soma from that time and through until today as well, I really feel that the most important thing is to think about how we can protect human lives.
ともすると、経済を発展させることが幸せにつながるんだというふうに思い込んでいる人が多いことと思いますけれども、東日本大震災、まあ、とりわけ東京電力福島第一原子力発電所の爆発事故で私たちが学んだことは、経済発展だけで幸せになるわけではなくて、まあ、この原発事故で地域が失われ、家族が失われ、 町がバラバラにされるということを学びました。
And so, you know, many people may believe that it is economic development which brings happiness. However, through the Great East Japan Earthquake and Tsunami, and particularly through the TEPCO Fukushima Daiichi Nuclear Power Plant explosion, we learned that economic development alone cannot create happiness. Through this disaster, that so many people who lost their homes, who lost their families, whose families were divided, this has really shown that this is the case.
南相馬では津波でも大変多くの人が犠牲になりましたけれども、津波を経験しなかった人も多くいます。そして、まあ、残念ながら原発事故で放射能被曝をしたり、まあ、市街へと避難させられることで、まあ、家族がバラバラになって、もう本当に市長また市役所に対して怒りいっぱいで声を寄せてくる市民も多かったです。
In the case of Minami Soma, of course, there were many who suffered greatly directly as a result of the tsunami. But even amongst those people who did not directly experience the tsunami have also suffered greatly as well due to the nuclear power plant disaster.This is through, for example, the exposure to radiation, through to being forced to evacuate and having their families separated. And as the mayor, as the city hall as well, we of course had many residents who were coming to voice their anger at the situation to us.
私は市民から、まあ、国や東電に代わって市長としてまた 市の代表としてさまざまな怒りや叱責を受けてきましたけれども、この放射能災害、原子力災害によって被災した人に対しては、常に皆さんは命があっていいですねっていう話をしてきました。
So I, of course, being the representative of the city, had to receive many of these criticisms, listen to these voices of anger from the people.You know, on behalf, whether it's of the national government or of TEPCO in regards to this difficult situation as well. And those who suffered through particularly the nuclear power plant disaster, they often said, well, at least they have their lives.
確かに被爆させられたり避難させられたりした人々からは、その想定外の災害に対して怒りが来るのは当然だと思います。しかし、津波で亡くなった方々は、命がなくなって声も出せない状態であるということを彼らには、まあ、残念ですけれども申し上げざるを得ませんでした。
Of course, for those people who were exposed to radiation, who had to flee and evacuate from the city, it is only natural that they would feel this anger against this, you know, unexpected, this unpredictable disaster which occurred as well.However, at the same time, I also felt that I had to say to them, those whose lives were lost in the tsunami, they're not able to stand up and voice anything at all now.
福島第一原発事故で南相馬市は、まあ、避難をさせられただけではなくて、まあ、20キロ、30キロ、まあ、30キロ圏外と、まあ、最初に3つに分断されましたけれども、その後も帰還困難区域であるとか、居住制限区域であるとか、避難指示解除準備区域であるとか、まあ、計画的避難区域であるとか、さらには特定避難勧奨地点であるとか、国の原子力災害対策本部が設置したすべての地域が南相馬市に設定されてしまいました。
Of course, you know, the people who had to evacuate or the situation of evacuation from Minami Soma City was one of the key factors following the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant disaster. But not only this, the fact that the city was really divided into three amongst the 20, 30 and then beyond that kilometer zones in radius from the nuclear power plant. Actually, Minami Soma as a city is home to each of the different kinds of categories which were set up by the national government's emergency headquarters, the difficult to return zone, the restricted inhabitant zone, the preparation for the lifting of evacuation order zone, the planned evacuation order zone, special recovery zone. Each of these kinds of categories which were set up by the national government are all contained within the one city.
この原発事故によって まず先ほど申し上げましたように地域がバラバラにされましたけれども、その後遺症は未だかって続いておりますし、確かに避難指示は解除できたんですけれども、残念ながらこの線引きによる差別感が今でも解消されておりませんし、避難指示区域内に以前住んでいた1万4千人のうち避難指示区域内に戻った方々はまだ3800人とか、まあ、4千人を割るような状況ですので、後遺症として非常に強く残っているというか、被害を最も大きく受けていると思います。
And so through this disaster, as I mentioned, the entire community, the city was truly divided. And the aftermath of that, the impacts or effects of that are still continuing today. Even as the evacuation zones have been lifted, the fact that there were these lines drawn between the community has led to this kind of differentiation or discrimination, which is still continuing today as well. Of the area which was within the evacuation or the mandatory evacuation zone, there were 14,000 people living there priorly before. However, of that, just under 4,000 people, around 3,800 people have returned to live there. So we can see that the aftermath of the situation and really the ongoing damages are still very strong.
まあ、20キロ圏内の街づくりはまだまだ取り掛かったばかりといっても過言ではありませんけれども、これから解除されるであろう双葉郡の地域を考えていくと、例えば2万1000人住んでいた浪江町がまだ1500人しか戻れておりませんし、双葉町はゼロですし、大熊町もまだ500人まで満たないぐらいしか戻れておりません。まあ、富岡町にしても1500人まで行くか行かないかぐらいの状況ですので、原発事故がどれほど地域を破壊してしまったかということが、この帰還した方々の数字を見るだけでも明らかだと思います。
And so I think we are really only at the very starting point of rebuilding the community for the areas within the 20 kilometer zone as well.If we consider not only Minamisoma, but for example, the municipalities or the towns within next door Futaba County as well, even though many places have had the evacuation orders lifted, if we take, for example, the town of Namie, which had a population prior to the disaster of 21,000 people, now it has only 1,500 people living there. In Futaba, the population is still zero. In Okuma town, it is now less than 500 people. And even the town of Tomioka is only around 1,500 people as well. So if we look at these numbers of people who have returned to live in their towns once again, even as the evacuation orders have been lifted, we can see how the nuclear power plant disaster has truly destroyed the community.
政府は、原発事故あったにもかかわらず、当時は福島の復興なくして日本の再生なしということを、まあ、野田総理大臣をはじめ安倍総理大臣もずっと話してきたんですけれども、残念ながら福島の復興が進まない状況の中で原発の再稼働を進めてきました。
The Japanese government, despite the situation or looking at the situation of the nuclear power plant disaster, has always been saying that without the recovery of Fukushima, the full recovery of Japan on the whole will not be possible. This is something which, you know, the former Prime Minister Noda was saying and Prime Minister Abe was also repeating as well. However, unfortunately, the reality is that there is no, well, the recovery of Fukushima is not progressing.And despite this, the government is now trying to go forward with restarting nuclear power plant.
福島第一原発事故後、南相馬市は全国各地へ全ての都道府県に避難をしましたけれども、政府は再稼働にあたって避難計画を義務付けることを 再稼働の条件の一つに義務付けました。
So after the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant disaster, residents of Minamisoma were actually evacuated to every single prefecture throughout the whole of Japan. They were divided throughout the country in this way. Since the disaster, the government has put in place as a condition for the restart of nuclear power plants, for evacuation plans for the local、host community to be mandatory.
7万人を超える市民の命を預かる市長として私が経験して思うのは、避難しなければいけないような避難計画を前提とするような原発の再稼働は、また避難させることを前提として計画されているエネルギー計画というのは、まさにバカバカしいとしか思えません。
So from my perspective, as having been, you know, the mayor of a city and being responsible for the lives of 70,000 people following the nuclear power plant disaster, from this experience, I truly feel that trying to restart nuclear power plants on the precondition of needing these evacuation plans, you know, showing that they are so risky that they need these plans in place, or even having energy plans which are based on considering the need for such an evacuation is something that can only be described as foolish.
経済発展のために原発推進することを政府は進めてきましたけれども、この政府のエネルギー政策は間違いであったということを福島第一原発事故は証明したと思います。
The Japanese government has continued to promote the use of、nuclear power. However, I think the disaster at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant has truly shownthat using this as the basis for the energy plan was wrong.
原発事故で放射性廃棄物の除染をしなければならなかったり、除染した廃棄物を中間貯蔵施設へ運ばなかったりしなければなりませんが、スケジュールは全く遅れておりますし、廃炉についても残念ながら見通しが立っていないというのが現実だと思います。
So when we consider the nuclear power plant disaster or following this, of course, there was the plans or it needed the plans for decontamination of the areas impacted by the radioactive contamination. It was said that this waste, the decontaminant or the waste which comes up from the decontamination process would be transported to the interim storage facility. However, the schedule which was in place for this is completely off now. It is completely、behind schedule and delayed. Also, in regards to the plans for the decommissioning of the plant,There is also really no clear prospect for the schedule for this.
先月の13日に震度6を超える地震をまた経験しましたけれども、この地震によって福島第一原発構内の汚染水タンク53基がずれた。または使用済み核燃料プールから水が漏れた、そして汚染水処理は全く進まないという現実を我々は見せつけられています。
Just recently on February 13, of course, there was a major earthquake in Fukushima,、which was on the Japanese scale of more than 6. At this time, there were also various impacts on the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, which have come to light since then as well. It's clear that the 53 tanks containing the contaminated water on site shifted, also that there was water leaked from the spent fuel pools on site as well. So we can really see that this decommissioning process of the plant is really not underway fully.
原発の立地自治体でなかった南相馬市が最も多くの人が犠牲になったり避難を余儀なくされたこともあって、2011年の段階で原発に頼らないエネルギー政策を進めるということを再生可能エネルギービジョン策定で明確にしました。
So as the city of Minami Soma, which was not directly the host to the nuclear power plant as a municipality,and yet had so many lives lost and so many people evacuating away from the city at the time in the year of the disaster in 2011, we announced our renewable energy vision to create a city which would not rely on nuclear power for energy.
10年経つ現在において、まあ、太陽光であるとか風力発電を通じた再生可能エネルギーで、まあ、市内での電力需要のおおよそ 94% まで今年2021年3月末には達成できる見通しになっています。
And now it is expected that 10 years on from then, mostly through solar and wind power, we are able to use renewables to meet the local demand for electricity of actually up to 94%. This is expected by the end of March 2021.
原子力発電は最も危険であると、また環境に対しても最も汚染するエネルギーであるということを、そして最も値段が高いエネルギー政策であるということが、この原発事故で明らかになりました。
The nuclear power plant disaster has proved clearly that nuclear power is indeed the most dangerous form of energy. It is that which contaminates the environment the most, and it is also the most expensive.
まあ、原発事故で先ほど申し上げた原子力に頼らない町づくりを進めるということで、日本で初めて脱原発都市宣言もしてきました。
And as I mentioned, as a city which decided as our policy that we would not depend on nuclear power for our energy, 南相馬 was also the first city in Japan to declare itself a nuclear power free city as well.
今、まあ、世界中で、まあ、国連が中心となって CO2 ゼロの街づくりであるとか SDGs の推進であるとかいうことを積極的に推進していますけれども、南相馬市は2011年のあの東日本大震災と原発事故を経験した時点で、まあ、こういうことをしなければ安定したそして持続的な命の継続はできないということで脱原発宣言もし再生可能エネルギー計画を2030年まで100% にするということを目指してきました。
And so now, of course, the global trends and with the UN at the center of this is looking towards building communities that have, you know, zero carbon communities or looking at promoting the sustainable development goals as well. 南相馬 is a city which even at that very time of the disaster realized that we need to take these kind of steps in order to ensure that we can have sustainable and stable lives as well. That is why even at that time we decided to declare ourselves a nuclear power free city and to put in place this plan for renewable energies. We plan, or the city plans by 2030 to reach 100% renewables.
今日本ではオリンピックを開催することに対してさまざまな議論がありますけれども、私はこの原発事故を経験してまだまだ避難させられている市民が多い中、ましてやコロナ禍の中で政府が復興五輪って言ってきたことがいつの間にかコロナ禍克服五輪になってみたり、五輪をすることそのものが目的化していて、福島の復興とかコロナの克服というのが本来命を守るために最も大切なはずなのに、なぜかオリンピック推進だけが強調されるようなことについては非常に残念に思います。
So in Japan now, of course, there are various debates about the holding of the Olympics as well. But for me, you know, looking at the experience of the nuclear power plant disaster, considering that there are so many people still having to live in evacuation, and not only this, but having the COVID pandemic on top of that as well, it seems to me that, well, the government has been saying that this is the recovery Olympics following the disaster, but now all of a sudden this seems to have changed into the overcoming COVID Olympics in a way as well.Well, the recovery of Fukushima and the overcoming of COVID should be the most important priorities in order to truly protect people's lives. It seems that for some reason, the holding of the Olympics itself is now the main purpose of the government. That is the goal that they are aiming for. And I think that this is extremely unfortunate.
原発事故でまだまだ福島は風評被害から脱しきれておりませんし、原発事故を経験した多くの市民、県民にとっては心の傷が癒えていませんし、現実的に生活再建できている人が多くないことも事実です。まあ、このようなことから、いかに原発事故から脱して安全で 安心できる、そして命が担保されるような経済発展が最も重要なんだということが、この原発事故、そして東日本大震災からの教訓だと思います。
So the prefecture of Fukushima is still also suffering as a result of the so-called harmful rumors following the nuclear power plant disaster as well. Also, those citizens both of Minami-Soma and also the whole of Fukushima prefecture who experienced this disaster still have many psychological wounds and issues which are yet to heal as well. I think if we were to think about the number of citizens who have truly been able to rebuild their lives, unfortunately, it would not be a very large number as well. So when we consider this kind of situation, I think that the most important lesson that we must learn from the nuclear power plant disaster and indeed overall the Great East Japan earthquake and tsunami is how we can put in place economic development that can still allow for the safe and secure protection of people's lives.
原発事故直後から、市民が6万人以上避難をさせられた現実の中で、多くのお母さんたち、女性たち、子どもたちから、福島には帰らない、戻らないということを耳にしましたし、大きな声として突きつけられてきました。風評被害が、原発事故の風評被害が残る中で、放射能との戦いっていうのが今現在も続いています。人口減少を克服して、また新たな街づくりをするために、先ほど紹介していただいた、日本中どこでもやっていないような、また世界から注目されるようなロボット産業開発、ロボット実験施設を誘致することを決めて、昨年オープンいたしました。
And so looking at the situation or the reality that since the nuclear power plant disaster, well, immediately after 60,000 people evacuated away from the city, and of these are many mothers or women or children, and I hear their voices saying that they do not want to return to Fukushima. We are dealing with the issue of the remaining harmful rumors following the disaster, but also the ongoing struggle actually against radiation as well.In order to overcome this issue of the decline in population and to find a new way for community building in the place, this is why it was decided last year to open the new robot development or robot testing facilities in the city as a way to create a kind of facility which does not exist anywhere else in Japan and which can attract global attention.
原発事故でかわいそうな福島だとか福島を支援しなければならないっていうふうに考えてくれる人も本当に多くいましたし、現在も支援してもらっていることに対しては心から感謝を申し上げたいと思います。その一方で、私は福島にかわいそうだから支援しようということではなくて、福島に行きたがる関係性を福島で日本中、世界中どこでもやっていないようなことがやれている新たな魅力を作り出すことが福島に来てもらえる方々も増えることと思いますし、ここに来て新たな研究をしたり新たな産業づくりをしてみたいという思いの人たちが、集結できるような場所としてロボットテストフィールドっていうのも設置したわけですけれども、今後日本中世界中の人たちがここで新たな、ロボット開発というか優しい人に優しい、地球に優しい産業開発ができることを願っています。
And so since the disaster, of course, there were many people who gave support for Fukushima. However, a lot of this perhaps was also due to feeling sorry for Fukushima or saying, oh, poor Fukushima, we have to do something for them.I am truly thankful today also for the great amount of support which we did receive. However, at the same time, I hope that this support, on the other hand, will not be received from a sense of pity, but rather from, you know, wanting to visit or connect with Fukushima as well. And this is why looking at how to build these kind of relationships with the place that makes you want to visit, makes you want to connect as well. And I think that these new kind of developments, such as the robot test field, is an example of how to have a new innovation or a new attraction in the place. which can encourage more people from throughout Japan and around the world to also come and visit Fukushima, and also for new research or new industrial development to come from there as well. And I hope that this can be done in industries which are indeed positive for both people and planet.
震災直後、私が YouTube 発信をして以来、毎回外国人特派員協会の会員の皆さんをはじめとして、世界中のジャーナリストたちが南相馬市をはじめ、福島の現実を取材しに入ってきていただいていること、また継続的に取材していただいていることに改めて感謝を申し上げたいと思います。まあ、あの時に、はい。
I would like to take this opportunity, first of all, to remember back to the time immediately following disaster when I issued the plea on YouTube. And this led to great attention from many journalists around the world, and particularly from the members of the FCCJ who came to Minami Soma, came to cover the reality in the city and also in Fukushima broadly, and continue to cover it to this day as well. I would like to express my gratitude for that.
まあ、日本のマスコミが原発事故後南相馬市から福島から去っていった現実の中で、海外のメディア、ジャーナリストの人たちが積極的に入ってきてくれて、取材をしていただいたことで、多くの市民、まあ、私を含めて福島が励まされてきたことも事実ですので、まあ、今後このようなこと自体が起こらないことを願ってはおりますけれども、まあ、ジャーナリストの皆さんは現場で起きていることを素直に取材発信していただいて、世界中の皆さんに起きている現実をしっかりと知らせ、そしてそこで何を知らせながら住民を助けていかなきゃいけないか、真実を伝えなきゃいけないかということを考えていただくことを続けていただければありがたいと思います。今日は本当にこういう機会をいただいたことに感謝を申し上げたいと思います。
And so following the nuclear power plant disaster, much of the Japanese media left Minami Soma, left the city immediately following the disaster. However, the international media continued to actively cover the situation on the scene. As a result, I believe that many people in Fukushima, including me personally, also were greatly encouraged. Of course, from now, what is most important is to ensure that such a disaster does not happen again as well. But I hope that the media, the journalists will continue to make their efforts to cover indeed what is actually happening on site, you know, the reality of how things are on the ground, to tell people around the world about this reality. And at the same time as telling this or sharing this truth, conveying this truth, looking at how to support the residents as well. So I thank you for your ongoing or continuing efforts for that and for the opportunity to speak today.
Thank you very much, Mayor Sakurai. At this point, we will open up the floor for a journalist here. If you have questions, please go ahead. If not, we've got some questions that we've already been gathering online.
ではこれで質疑応答に入りますが、まずは会場の質問の方からお受けしたいと思います。その後、オンラインの方で届いている質問に移ります。
All right, our first question comes from Pio D'Amelia of Sky TV. He asks,Mayor Sakurai, do you regret that some Toden managers, TEPCO, I assume, have not been criminally prosecuted?
一つ目はイタリアのスカイテレビのピオデミリアからの質問となります。東電の役員が今でも、まあ、その責任を取っていない、責任が追及されていないということは、まあ、残念なことだと思いますでしょうか。
よろしいでしょうか。
はい、お願いします。
まさにその通りだと思います。残念ながら被災した方々、まあ、とりわけ津波で助かったかもしれない人たちが原発事故で避難をさせられたことで、まあ、救助もできないまま、捜索できない状況にも追い込まれましたし、現場の人たち、特に被災した人たちが地域を奪われたり、本来あるべきではならないあってはならない事態に追い込まれて、責任というよりも被害だけを受けてしまっている現実を見ると、いろんな裁判はありますけれども、残念ながら東電は会社の役員も含めて全く責任を取っていないと思います。
Yes, very much so. You know, unfortunately, those people who suffered as a result of the disaster, if we think about those people, perhaps who survived the initial tsunami, but were not able to be found then, or there was not able to have search relief efforts following the tsunami because of the nuclear power plant disaster, for example, or those who survived the tsunami, but then had to evacuate away from their homes, who lost their homes, their hometowns as a result of the nuclear power plant disaster. When we think about how much these people truly suffered on the ground, continue to suffer, this is something, you know, very severe situation. Yet, if we look at the issue of responsibility, despite the fact that there are many different legal proceedings which have been initiated, have been led, we still have a situation where TEPCO, including the executives, have not taken responsibility.
もう一つ加えて申し上げさせていただければ、まあ、東電の社員の皆さん、福島に派遣されてきた社員の皆さんは、被害の実態とか、被害者の状況を見て心から本当に謝罪をしている方々、まあ、会社を辞めて福島を支援している方々もいらっしゃいますので、まあ、社員すべてを悪いと私は申し上げませんが、先ほど申し上げたように役員は責任を取っているのか、東京電力は責任を取っているのかということについて言えば、最初の答えで申し上げた通り責任は取っていないと思います。
And to add one initial, one additional point to that as well, when we look at the TEPCO staff, who were sent to Fukushima, I think that many of them truly did understand, look at the reality of the damages, the impact of the disaster, and also the situation of the victims of the survivors as well. Many of them, you know, made very heartfelt, sincere apologies to the local residents. Some of them have quit working at TEPCO and are supporting Fukushima in different ways today as well. So I would like to make clear that I'm not saying that all of the staff or personnel of TEPCO are indeed bad. However, as I mentioned, as to whether the company or the executives have taken responsibility, as mentioned, that is not the case.
Our next question comes from Richard Cicillo, actually a few questions from Indonesia. Media. He asked, Mayor, how can you bring people back to Minami Soma? What kind of interesting or speciality of the city will kind of rekindle or boost the population again? And have you considered consulting other countries in helping Minami Soma to recover?
いや、次もオンラインでインドネシアのリチャード・スシロさんからの質問になります。いくつか質問ございますが、まあ、まず南相馬に人々がまた戻るように、まあ、例えば南相馬のその特別な、まあ、その地域の、まあ、特別な物産であるとか特徴であるとか、また人々が再び南相馬を訪問したい、南相馬に住みたいと思わせるような、まあ、取り組みがあればぜひ紹介していただきたいということと、また南相馬の復興、まあ、再生のためには、例えば外国に何かをお願いする、要請するようなことを考えられているでしょうか。お願いします。
ありがとうございます。南相馬市の人口について言えば、居住人口がまあ、5万4千人弱まで戻っています。産業について言えば復興に関わる土木建設業は多分ゴールドラッシュ的なバブル的な仕事になったと思います。そして除染について言えば全国から除染作業員が南相馬市に一時期8700人も入ってくるほど多くの人たちが除染作業に入ってきました。しかしながら彼らが、まあ、去っていった後、南相馬市の産業はどれほど回復してきているのかというふうに言えば、まあ、サービス産業としては8割を超えた回復になっておりますけれども、まあ、残念ながら医療であるとか介護であるとか肝心な女性たちが働く場としての人が全く足りていないのが現実です。海外からの支援という形について言えば、確かに来ていただけるのはありがたいんですけれども、南相馬市の農業であるとか漁業であるとか林業であるとか、最も重要な基幹産業の を立て直しというのが、まあ、この原発事故、放射能災害によって一番厳しい状況に追い込まれています。まあ、こういうことを回復するためにも、また新たな人を育てていくことが必要だと思いますし、まあ、協力について言えば、海外の皆さんの協力も得られれば、それも一つの方法かもしれません。
So in regards to the city of Minamisoma, the population has now recovered to around 54,000 people. So that's the number of people now living in the town. As to industry for the area, for the city, the robot development field, robot testing field, which I mentioned, was somewhat of a bubble for creating employment. There was a kind of a gold rush for the development and the construction and so on in regards to this new industry. Also, another factor or industry which had a great impact as well was, of course, the decontamination efforts. At the peak, there were around 8,700 workers involved in the decontamination efforts who were temporarily living in the city of Minamisoma as well. However, of course, after they have left, as to whether how the industry is, how the economy is, and so on, is an issue. Within the service industry in Minamisoma, it could be said to have recovered to around 80%, I would say. However, if you look at, for example, the health or medical fields or also care-related fields, which are fields where there tends to be a high number of women who are working as well, there is actually very severe insufficiencies there as well, and not enough people there too. When we look at the question about support from foreign countries as well, of course, coming to visit Minamisoma and so on is one way to support as well. However, the most severe difficulty or situation that we are facing now is indeed how to recover the core primary industries, you know, the fishing, agriculture, and forestry of Minamisoma as well. And this is what is the most difficult due to the impacts of the nuclear power plant and radiation as well. Therefore, I think that in order to have this, have a true recovery or bring the people back to Minamisoma, it will be necessary to nurture different human resources or people in different fields as well. This is perhaps one way that there could be support from other countries for as well.
Our next question, Teddy.
で次会場から神保さんお願いします。
桜さんどうも神保です。よろしくお願いします。はい、桜さんにこの間 の前回の2018年の選挙のことをお伺いしたいんですけどもね。はい、日本において地方自治体の、まあ、首長がですね、まあ、特にこの場合は原発が大きいと思いますが、中央政府の政策に真っ向から、反対をした場合にするようなその首長がですね、その実際に、まあ、選挙もしくはその自治体においてさまざまな政策を執行する上で、どういうハンデを背負うことになるんでしょうか、あるいはどういう、まあ、妨害を受けるっていうとちょっと言い過ぎかもしれませんが、中央に反対することによって地方の首長がどういうそのデメリットをですね覚悟しなくてはならないのか、それからそれがまあ2018年あれ確か201票差でしたっけね、市長が惜しくもまあ自公が推す候補に負けられましたけど、特にまたその選挙がどのように戦いにくくなるのか、どのように不利になるのか、それからまあついでですので気がつけばもう2021年なので、市長もう来年次の選挙ですが、もう出馬の是非はお決めになったかどうか、もしあればお願いします。
My name is Jimbo. I have several questions. First of all, related to the 2018 mayoral elections in Minamisoma as well. In the case in Japan, for a local municipal mayor or leader to directly go in opposition to a policy of the central, the national government,I would like to ask for a mayor standing in election or even for implementing various policies on the municipal level, what kind of difficulties or obstacles do you come across, as a mayor going in direct opposition to the national government, whether it's in regards to the time of the election or the implementing the policies as well? I believe that in the 2000 election, you were unsuccessful by around 201 votes at the time. So I'd like to ask if you can speak first about that experience.And the second question is, next year there will also be the election once again for the mayor. I'd like to ask if you are planning to be running again at that time.
はい、ありがとうございます。まあ、神保さんの質問っていうのはすごく的を得ているなっていうふうに思ってるんですけれども、2014年の選挙の時に、 まあ、私は脱原発ということを明確に掲げて選挙をしました。一方で沖縄県の名護市の稲嶺市長は、まあ、基地反対、辺野古基地反対を掲げて、あの時は2人とも当選をしたんですね。しかしながら2018年の名護市長選と南相馬市長選は負けました。これは、まあ、名護の、まあ、辺野古の問題も、まあ、国策に反対してきた稲嶺さんを明確に落とそうという動きがあったと思いますし、まあ、国策として、まあ、基地問題、特に翁長知事を先頭とする沖縄県の住民の思いと、基地推進をする日本政府の感覚の違い、また私のことについて言えば、原発推進は絶対やめないという自民党政府と、まあ、現場の住民の命と暮らしを見つめてきている私からすれば、原発事故で破壊されるようなことはさせたくないという思いで、脱原発をずっと推進してきたわけですけれども、まあ、これは国策に全く逆らっているということだったと思います。ただ、私は政府とのやり取りもしてきましたけれども、まあ、官僚、霞が関官僚とも多くお話し合いとか交渉してくる中で、必ずしも官僚そのものが、政府と同じ感覚でいる人たちだけではないということも感じてました。ですので、日本政府がしっかりとした方針をとりわけ、まあ、国民の命とか安心できる暮らしを最優先する政権にであれば、官僚も誇りを持って推進に携わるであろうと思いました。まあ、次の選挙の問題について言えば、つまり負けた原因について言えば、まあ、国策に逆らってきたからだということは明確に分かりますし、その背景に、まあ、申し上げるのは結構きついことではあるんですけれども、公明党創価学会の存在がございます。まあ、彼らは名護市長選の時もそうですし、南相馬市長選の時も明確に自民党候補者を支持するという形をとって、創価学会に聞けば、もう桜井さんのところには厳しいという声も受けました。ここに象徴されるように、まあ、政権が何らかの意図、または何らかの利権があって、まあ、候補者を潰したいという思いがあったんだろうと思います。ただ、負けましたけれども、幸いに住民の多くは、まあ、私を支持してくれたことも事実ですし、今変わったことで、逆に不満が高まってきているのも事実ですので、まあ、この市民の感覚というのもしっかりと受け止めて、まあ、次の判断もしていきたいなというふうに考えています。
Thank you. That is a question which is indeed very much on target. If we look back, first of all, to the 2014 election, I was very clearly against nuclear power in my platform.The same year, there was also the mayoral election in the city of Nago in Okinawa as well, which was debating around the construction of a new base at Henoko. And at the time, the mayor Inamine, who was very clearly or obviously against the construction there, was also successful. Both of us were successful in our elections with those platforms, which did go directly against the national government.However, then if we look to 2018, the elections by us both in Nago City and Minami Soma were lost as well. I think that if we look at the case of Henoko and Mayor Inamine, there was a very clear move to make him lose because he was going up directly against in opposition to this national policy of in regards to the US base issue as well. Despite the fact that he had very strong support from many of the people as well, we could see that because he was going directly head on against the government, there were these moves to ensure that he would not be successful. In my case as well, it was clear that the LDP would not be willing to give up their policy of promoting nuclear power. Yet for me, as the local municipal leader in the place, where the nuclear power plant happened, I have a very strong anti-nuclear power policy to make sure that we cannot let another disaster, you know, destroy people's lives and livelihoods, as I saw happened after the disaster as well. Therefore, this meant that I was going directly head on against the national policy as well. However, I have had, of course, various dialogue and negotiations with people within the government and also the bureaucrats in Kasumigaseki as well. And as to whether they themselves all share the same kind of opinions or sense as the government, I do not believe that this is necessarily the case. If the Japanese government were to have a solid policy which would put people's safety and lives at the center, I think that the bureaucrats could then actively work to implement that. However, you know, that is not the case there as well. So I think that it's clear that the reason that I lost in the 2018 election is indeed because I was directly in opposition to the national government. And this is something which is perhaps a little bit difficult to say, but in the background to that was the presence of Kometo and Soka Gakkai, actually. This was the case both in Nago and also in Minami Soma, where they clearly were in support of the LDP candidate as well. I think this symbolizes the fact that the government, if the government has their particular will or interest, they are able to, you know, quash a particular candidate in these kind of situations. However, despite the fact that I lost in that election, you know, many of the citizens did support me at the time and continue to do as well. And I think that what we have seen has changed is that more and more people are voicing their dissatisfaction about the current situation as well. So I am very much paying attention to people's, you know, sense, people's situation and so on. And I will base my decision on what to do next on that.
All right, we have two questions that we've received online and we'll try to get everyone in. So we may go a tad over noon, if that's all right, Mayor Snodgrass.
あと2つほどオンラインで届いている質問がありますが、少し12時を過ぎるかもしれないんですけれども、もう数分ぐらいよろしいでしょうか、桜井さん。
あ、大丈夫です。
Yes, all right. Our first question comes from Martin Fackler, who covered the disasters of 10 years ago and is writing freelance now. He mentions, you know, the environment 10 years ago really wasn't that social media friendly, or not everyone's kind of default was YouTube or the internet. But your video on YouTube in March 2011 did receive global attention. I watched this morning one that you directly sent to the people of Hawaii. Was that your expectation at the time you made it? And what kind of provoked or inspired you to go viral?
で次はマーティン・ファクラーからの質問になります。以前はニューヨーク・タイムズの記者で、現在はフリーランスとして活動している記者なんですが、まあ、当時は必ずしも SNS などがそれほど、まあ、発展していなかった時代だったと思いますが、市長の YouTube での2011年の3月のビデオは非常に、まあ、世界の注目を集めることになりました。それは当時、まあ、予想していたことだったのでしょうか。そのビデオをなぜその時に作ろうと思ったのか、実際今朝も司会の方がハワイに直接届けられたビデオを見たんですけれども、まあ、その当時の YouTube を使うことを決めた理由などについて教えてください。
はい、ありがとうございます。マーティンには震災直後から取材していただいて本当に感謝をしています。まあ、YouTube を、まあ、使うっていう発想は私にはありませんでしたが、残念ながら日本のメディアが、南相馬市から出て行ってしまって、取材はすべて電話取材だったんですね。ところが30キロ屋内退避が決まってから、南相馬市には物資が全く入らなくなって、機敏状態に追い込まれたような状況になりました。まあ、ここをなんとかしなきゃいけないというのが私の思いでしたし、市内にはまだ2万人以上の方々がいらっしゃっていたのも事実ですので、この人たちの生活を支えるために、とにかく助けが欲しいと。まあ、誰であれ、助けてもらわなきゃいけないっていう思っていたところに、たまたま、まあ、国際基督教大学卒業した私の後輩がボランティアに来て、それで、まあ、カメラに向かって喋っていただければ、私たちが責任を持って英語のテロップをつけて YouTube で発信しますと。言ってくれたのが3月の24日で、まあ、その結果、まあ、英語のテロップがついたことで、まあ、世界中に発信され、 世界中のメディアが3月の末からもうほとんど毎日のように、まあ、線量計をつけタイベックススーツを着て私のところに取材に来るようになりました。まあ、これが、まあ、私 YouTube で従来のメディアと全く違う発信力があるなということを感じましたし、まあ、その後もさまざまな方法で南相馬市の状況を発信することについてはやっていかないとこの地域の再生がないということも考えてきたのは事実です。
So thank you very much. And first of all, I'd like to say thank you, Martian, for covering Minami Soma and you're speaking to me so many times, including since right after the disaster as well. At the time, I didn't actually even consider or think of using YouTube as well. However, we were in a situation where the Japanese media had all left Minami Soma and the only coverage, the only reporting was just being done via telephone. Then there was the order given for people within the 30 kilometer radius to stay inside, which meant that materials were just not entering Minami Soma at all. It was really a situation where the residents were almost being, you know, starved alive. I felt that needed to do something to help them something about this situation as well. There were in fact still around or more than 20,000 people remaining in the city at that time. So I felt that I needed to find help from anyone anywhere in order to somehow support these people in their lives as well. It happened that one of my kohai, someone I knew who had graduated from ICU, was actually volunteering or had come to Minami Soma to volunteer. And he suggested that if I were to speak to the camera, then, well, he and his team would take the responsibility of adding English subtitles to this and disseminating it internationally as well. This was on March 24. As a result of having the English subtitles on this video, it meant that my voice, my plea was really conveyed to people around the world. And so since the end of March, really every day I had so many international media who actually came and were covering the situation in Minami Soma, you know, wearing their dosimeters and their protective suits and so on, but really on the ground talking about what was happening there as well. So this made me realize that using YouTube or these kind of methods has a completely different power to, you know, traditional kinds of media as well. And from that moment, I came to realize that we needed to use these different kinds of measures and different kinds of media to share the situation in Minami Soma in order to actually have the city rebuild.
Our final question today, Mayor Sakurai, actually comes from a student journalist at Temple University named Aaron Bassano. And Aaron asks, are Fukushima fishermen and farmers against the central government's release of contaminated water into the sea while at the same time promoting Fukushima's fruits and vegetables, seafood, and meat?
次が最後の質問になりますが、テンプル大学の学生の記者からの質問です。エリン・バサノさんからの質問です。福島の漁師さん、そして農家の人たちの意見についてなんですけれども、日本政府が今、福島の農産物、魚などを、推進しているにもかかわらず、その汚染水を海に放出するという計画に、福島の漁師、そして福島の農家は反対されているでしょうか。
はい。特に漁業の話からすると、直接、汚染水を海に放出される、被害者でもあるわけで、彼らは10年経った今も試験操業でしかないんですね。多くの漁獲した、魚類を毎日、放射性物質の含有量を測って、今現在はほぼ放射性物質が出てこない状況になっているわけですけれども、それでも汚染水を放出されることでまた、放射性物質の汚染と戦わなきゃいけないのかという懸念もあって全漁連をはじめとして反対しています。農業についてもまだまだ安全性は確認されているとはいえ風評被害の脱出までには至っていないのが現実です。
So first of all, especially in regards to the fishing industry, you know, the contaminated water in the ocean is indeed, well, they will be the direct victims of this as well. We are now at the stage 10 years following the disaster where the fishing industry in Fukushima is still really only at the initial testing stage, even one decade later as well. Every day, you know, much of what is being caught off the coast is going through very stringent monitoring procedures to look for the rate more or to check the radiation levels. And they're finally at the situation where there is almost no radiation detected in what is being caught there as well. However, if this contaminated water will be released in the ocean, this means that the fishermen will once again need to start this fight against the contamination, against the radiation as well. Therefore, they are indeed in opposition of this, including also the National Fisheries Co-op as well. In regards to agriculture, there is perhaps, you know, more where the safety of this as an industry or the produce and so on has been confirmed. However, they are still dealing with the issue of the so-called harmful rumors as well.
All right. Well, with that question, we'll close today. I'd like to thank our tech team that made today's virtual event possible, our translator, Mary Joyce, all of you for your interest, and in particular, Mayor Sakurai. We commonly offer a one-year honorary membership to all of our guests, and we look forward to the day where you can come and visit our club again, and we can thank you in person.
では桜井さん本日はありがとうございます。通常1年間の名誉会員証をお渡ししているんですけれども、本日ちょっと遠隔ということで直接お渡しすることはできないんですが、また東京に直接来られることが可能になりましたら、ぜひまたこちらの協会の方お越しください。その時直接お礼を申し上げたいと思います。本日はありがとうございました。
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
Our pleasure, sir. For those online or even, Mayor, if you're interested, tomorrow we will have the governor of Fukushima, who it's been obviously 10 years since, almost to the day. So we will host Governor Masao Uchibori tomorrow, who will discuss events and recovery over the last decade.
本日の会見はこれで終了となります。明日同じ時間に福島県知事の内堀さんもこちらで会見をされます。ご注目ください。ありがとうございます。
ありがとうございました。